going to read off a script too. Good afternoon. My name is Donald Lung. I graduated from DBS in 1999. That was 19 years ago, and I'm having my 20th reunion next year. My DBS journey started when I transferred into DPS at Primary 4 from LaSalle. My late father also went to LaSalle. So any fathers here today who did not go to DBS, don't feel discouraged. My dad went to a rival school. I went on to DBS all the way until Form 7 and graduated and went on to study in the US at Yale University. The first impression I had when I started at DPS was the English was really difficult. In LaSalle, every subject except for English was taught in Chinese. So the first year at DPS was really just catching up with all the subjects which were all taught in English. Things got smoother soon, and the DPS years went by very quickly and happily. But the years that really changed me and shaped me were the years I had in DPS. Sometimes you might have the misconception that sports and music are the only areas that DPS cared about. And you hear stories of talented sportsmen or music prodigies from DPS all the time. I was none of that. Yes, I sang on the choir, but my main activity was a Boy Scout, and DPS welcomed that and encouraged that. Same as they encourage other boys who found meaning in publishing, photography, debate, computer programming, just to name a few. My life in DBS was basically constantly being inspired by senior boys, by students, who went down amazing paths before me. Shortly after I entered DBS, I heard about stories of a senior boy by the name of Isaac Bunn, who in the eyes of a former boy was just legendary. He won a full scholarship to UWC and eventually another full scholarship to Cambridge. He had already left DBS then, and the only physical evidence I see of Isaac is his name being engraved in the school hall for winning a scholarship called the Wilcox Scholarship. So you can imagine how lucky and ecstatic I felt when I won the same scholarship as Isaac. This mythical seeing whom I've never met. I was never the top boy in Form 1, nor in Form 2, only in Form 3. Maybe praying a lot that someday I could be like Isaac did help. And who would have guessed that today I would be working for the same senior boy who inspired me along my DBS life. I was of course happy winning that scholarship, and it provided me a lot of relief and comfort to our family when we needed it. My father passed away when I was in Form 5. But if there's one thing that DBS has taught me over the years, it is to be humble. You might have a better short-term memory, but there are a million other things that your classmates can do better than you because of the diversity of talents that DBS has cultivated. Contrary to the best of the best slogans that we always shout outwardly, inwardly, we know that there are always things you can learn from the person beside you or from senior boys or junior boys years above or below you. DBS was a continual learning process for me, not just knowledge from books, but also knowledge of life. Senior boys provided role models of what's achievable in life. Information wasn't as free-flowing back then, and seeing senior boys graduating into universities around the world gave me the encouragement I needed to at least try. Neither of my parents studied in the US, and never in my wildest dreams did I imagine I could go to Yale. To give you a sense, I only applied in Form 7, which means I was also taking the A-levels and also aiming for Hong Kong universities at the same time. Plan A was in the US, and Plan A was certainly not Yale. Were it not for DBS, I would not be where I am today. To this day, I'm still amazed by what DBS boys past and present could achieve, and I'm always inspired. But most importantly, I'm grateful for what DBS has taught me, and I owe the whole part of what I am today to the character, identity, and values that DBS has provided me. And this will stay with me for life. Thank you.